Good morning, everyone. My name is Christian from Two-Headed Wolf Gaming, and welcome back to Crusader Kings 3 with the campaign of East Anglia, now being known as an empire. And I will take a suggestion that I received. It's something I proposed at the end of the last game, but someone agreed that we are not in the East anymore, so we could call ourselves Anglia, and as an adjective we can go with Anglian. I think it sounds great, it looks great also, so I think we can continue the game as we're trying to finish taking over the British Isles. Let's quickly check where are we at as far as the popular opinion. We are on plus, there's no penalties there. We are missing money because we spent a whole lot of them there. We can ask the head of faith for some gold, and I think I will do that. We don't want anything else from him at this point. We can negotiate an alliance with our son, so we will do so. Anything else here? Your son, heir, and player ward. Let's see, who is it? Him? Yep, an intelligent son, so we like him on that side. What else? You are intelligent as well. Low control in three of our counties. We can imprison some criminals. Duke Searle for being what? Murdered a family member? Oh, and he's excommunicated. So we could go ahead and imprison him, but I don't want that. What else do we want to do here? Few knights. We have too few knights, 8 out of 10. Okay, well, let's force him. Our brother-in-law and knight, that's okay. As long as our court is not fighting, that is okay. That's good. Brother-in-law. Okay, I think we're fine for now. Where are we at? So, monthly expenses, unraised men-at-arms cost us 5.6 gold per turn, and we're getting a 36.9 gold per turn. Are we holding too many domains? That was something I wanted to check. Absolute crown authority, one seat on the council, high taxes, and a few other things. You are a rival of us now. And it's mostly because you killed one of our family members. That's what we know about you. Yeah, I'm not sure what to do at the moment. I guess we'll just quickly check whether we can declare war on any of these. Either seize this territory or this one. Yeah, there's not a whole lot we can take from there. Or these islands. Okay, let's see. What else? Here in Altklut, we have, I think we have a truce. Yep, we don't want to go there yet. Here, declaring war. Oh, it's the same idea. We can declare war for these two. But probably go for Sudreyar first. Or no, this is Sudreyar. And the town of Carrick. Let's see, how is this territory? They have a village. They have a small fort here. In here. They also have a bastion, and that's it. There's no other villages in there. Ekines, do we have a truce? Oh, we do not. And we could go to war for most of their territories. Gain 80 fame. Your allies will share 800 prestige if you bring them in. Spends anti 80 prestige. Okay. I think it's the best time to do so. We are going to declare war here. We have the troops in place. We're just gonna raise them now. A new decision to hold a feast. Let's go ahead and do that. Let's see. I have considered your plight and decided to grant your request. May this help, these funds help you spread the true faith in your land. That is awesome. Let's hold the feast as well. I am honored by your request. I would gladly call you an ally. Great. Let's see. We can call on a bunch of house members here. Let's bring them in. It's not really necessary, but I think it's gonna help us. By having them help us in the war, it's gonna improve our relations. And we do want that to happen. A cherry gathering. Guests are gathered in the Great Hall, lords and ladies from near and far realms. Hey. Let's see. Good. So now we are like this. I am going to be sending these troops in order to fight over on that side. And these troops over here to start besieging some settlements. It was such a pleasant feast, but then he showed up. Can I not have a single evening unsullied by the invasive stench of Tuxerl? Worst of all is the nasal grinding of his voice. He sidles up to me. Why the sour face, Wulfnoth? East ruined by vassal, minor penalty and plus 20 stress, and we lost some opinion with him. Yeah, it's very unfortunate, but what can we do? My dear wife Margarita has been working hard to ensure that everything about the feast goes smoothly. The food arrives on time, the guests are all seated in the right place, and everyone seems content. With Margarita beside me at the great table, everything is ready. I squeeze her hand and smile at her before rising to announce the start of the celebration. Household efforts, direct vassal opinion plus 5, courtier and guest opinions plus 10, and we lose some stress, which is awesome. Yep, we're going forward here. Yeah, and now our guests are departing. We've improved some relations and received some prestige. How are our people? Well, they're doing okay. We've won another battle there. We will sit in place just to take over the hill fort. Okay, so there's this part. Oh, we saw this. We unfortunately cannot take it through this war. I think I'll speed it up by one more. We have plenty of troops at the moment to where we feel very confident. Okay, as soon as this siege is done, we're going to go south, fight them once again. Good, let's go there. Heir first in line to inherit Cappadocia. Cappadocia is where? Oh, here in Byzantium. Okay. We can negotiate an alliance with Constantine. Half brother and vassal. Sure, let's negotiate an alliance there as well. Marvelous. Mostly because we want to be protected from another one of those independence wars, right? I took his daughter as hostage. Yep, we are now ready already to inherit and enforce our demands. So be it. We are above our limit. Don't really want to keep the territories here. Yeah, and there's nothing really constructed in the area. So first of all, let's disband the soldiers. Let's check our... There's a son here, yep. And I want to grant you... these titles. That's what I want to do. I want to grant him those titles there. We're just gonna keep some of them. Look at that beautiful dragon. The Empire of Anglia. And then we have the Byzantine Empire here. They're at 1600 and I would like to go ahead and work on a scheme like that. Let's have our spy, because I think we're okay. Let's have our spy support our schemes and try to kill his wife. Maybe in the future then take care of some of his other allies. I hereby invite you to a feast at my court. Okay, it will be my pleasure. Every guest is gathered in the great hall and our gracious host Banmorad Nest has welcomed us all to the feast. Let's see, is she good? Oh, yeah, she has some skill. Infiltrators. It has come to my attention that some local commoners are moving to Warwick, to the capital of the Duke. We're trying to sway him, right? Yeah, let's not spend the money. How are we here? Ooh. You. Who are you? If I want to take it like this, oh, it's so this shows us by seeing these lines, this shows that we are pushing his claims. Let's see. So if we go ahead and do this, he becomes our vassal. He gets this territory. He becomes our vassal. Okay. Well, let's do this again. Now we've done something along these lines before. We pushed some claims. We pushed some claims of his. Consumption, frail. Okay, there is. He's still good. We tried to push some claims, but then they didn't become our vassal. Here it says that they become our vassal. So let's try this. I hope that this time it works and I hope he doesn't die before we manage to do... we manage to win the war, because that is a possibility as well. Okay, now split the troops. I'm gonna take the one with the besiegers and go over to his capital here with you. What I want to do is start taking some of these territories that are closer to us. Maybe even fight him a few times. They don't have a whole lot of troops, so this should really come in handy. Serendipitous espionage. It was not what Romila was hoping to find by spying on secret conversation, but discovering the truth about Basilius' unusual habits does not hurt. Ooh! Ooh! Now all of a sudden I don't really... So he... We have his secrets. We can blackmail him. Yeah, I don't want to kill her anymore. Do we want to be in bad diplomatic? I wanna see this go. Let's see. We are going here, hooks and secrets, let's expose. We've exposed him as a cannibal. That means his prowess is plus 2, okay. Stress loss plus 15%, natural dread of plus 20, opinion of cannibal characters plus 35. And, ooh, this is a crime in their country too. Or in their empire. Hey! And now there's a whole lot more who want to take him out. Siflid adopted Greek culture, that is unfortunate. Started a murder scheme against him, that's great. So we go for a hunt. Yeah, let's do that. Because we do have quite a bit of marshal, if I'm not mistaken. No, that's not that much. An available perk here. You do not lose piety or clergy opinion from torturing or executing others. Yeah, let's go this way. Hunt, rampaging boar. Just as my niece and I crest the hill, we hear it. The snapping of twigs, the rustle of branches, birds screaming in fright. They are the herald announcing its arrival. A massive boar heading straight at us. We could its path ends here with me. There's zero chance we die. There's a chance we get wounded. And there's a bigger chance that we get a strong fee. Or we can ask her for help. Let's see. Oh, we gained the trait wounded. Basilius Constantinos' nephew Albert is an ignorant man, and I find myself in his company. I am at his first wary. However, I soon realized that he is not averse to my company as I first thought. I am a wolf in sheep's clothing, closing in on my quarry. You grow closer to forming a friendship with him. Please, my friend, tell me about yourself. Yeah, let's play this game. Invalidated. Darn it. Yeah, that guy died. He was sick, so. Returning from the wild, the hunt is drawing to an end. We mount our horses and leave the farmland behind. Yeah, unfortunately, we didn't manage to do anything there. We can push those claims. A secret exposed. He has excused my vassal of having had extramarital affair with his lover, vassal in our realm. Okay. How could he defile the sanctity of marriage? Definitely. Let's quickly check. How are we doing here? With you? I don't think we need most of these people. Banished. Why are we imprisoned character can be banished from the realm? Which is arguably the hardest form of punishment. Banished landed rulers are deposed while banished courtiers have assets seized. Banishment without reason, e.g. some severe crime, is considered extremely tyrannically. Oro, our prisoner and daughter. She loses opinion of us. Yeah, let's leave them. Demand conversion here's with you. We'll do the same. I think we don't need these people. Even though we captured them, we can demand their conversion and have them leave. Okay. Where are we at as far as the region goes? He is Catholic. He is Catholic too. He is Catholic. He is a Saru. Yeah, he's not really happy with me. It's a bit difficult to. Okay. My agent Count Johannes approaches me with a bunch of parchment clutched in his hands. I found old architectural sketch of the Basilius castle. They might be a bit outdated, but look here. Let's go for the hidden. Get that +8 to scheme resistance. Ethelward came of age. That is wonderful. And he is a grey eminence. He's going to be a great heir. What should we marry you with? You know, I used to go for alliances a lot, but at this point I think I just want to inherit some really good traits. Like I have genius, but she's our niece. We need to find some outside of our court. Like we could even bring a beautiful Lucario's forgiving and patient wife? Yeah, let's do that. He loses some prestige, but that is okay. She seems pretty great at diplomacy, at least. Tourney troubles. As emperor, I have been obliged to attend local justing. Okay, what can we do? Because this is clearly boring. Push Sigelheim into the horse's water through to lead even things up. We lose some stress. Spend some time with our friend. Yeah, let's just spend some time with our friend. Okay. Don't really need to do much. My agents have scheduled a journey for Basilius Constantinos, which will take him them through the dark woods. All that is missing is the band of thugs. Sure, let's try to take him out. He has left the world sent off by Bandit Blade. As the travel party stopped to camp for the evening, bandits poured out from among the trees, calling for blood and gold. Conveniently, most of the bandits... Okay, so we were never found out. Now, Byzantine Empire is ruled by a 6-year-old boy. People aren't really happy with him. That might destabilize the region just enough. Our cousin created the cadet brand and another one to our family. So let's check out our household here. We have 1,000 points. Do we want anything else from here? Dread gain and courtier opinion? No, we do not. We will just be waiting to get the next level, probably here. Chance of reinforcing congenital traits, that means improve on what was on the trait that we already have. Our brother has died of great pox. Oh, how very unfortunate. Ooh, what is this? Or what was that? I have no idea. Let's see, what can we do here? We can go for a small war here. To take Altklut. And we will do that. How much penalties did we get from those two wars that we didn't finish? Well, none. So that is good. Or very little, maybe. There is an empty position as a spymaster. Let's check out who can we put. We can put this guy. This vassal. Let's try to sway him. Maybe in time we can even convert him to our cult, to our religion, which would be actually, he's zealous, so I'm not sure that we will be able to convert him. I don't know. Maybe just go on, make sure that we are on friendly terms. Is this war going bigger? Well, there is someone else. Oh, this territory? Yeah, I'm not gonna worry about that. So we're just gonna leave some besiegers there. Maybe even... Yeah, let's take 800 troops and bring them there. Oh, not everybody. The 800. That... Okay, you go there, and I just want this army. Let's see. You go home. You go home. These 3,000 troops, I want them there. Good. We have a new cadet branch being created by our brother. We are going to check 8 houses in total. Most of them died here. But we do have a bunch who are still alive today. Countess Helga of East CX. Yeah, it's really cool how far our faction has reached from the beginning of the game till now. Has been a difficult journey all in all. Okay, as soon as we take that town, we're gonna come here, attack these troops. He's bringing 20 troops, really? They should be staying home instead of bringing everybody in. But I'm sure with future updates there will be things like that. Okay, we are disbanding our armies again. We are taking a look here. -3 from offensive wars. This guy, can we declare a war on you? Yep, we can. We can go for either seize the chiefdom like that or through piety. We don't have places to use piety any longer. So I'll just go here. Let's see, is there any other place that you control? Yes, you control this size. So maybe... Nah, I don't know. Let's raise some of our troops here. And then split them up. I will bring those troops there. And I will disband these ones. I will just raise them in case there is going to be any kind of landing party here. For some reason they decided to come and attack me there. We captured his marshal and chancellor after winning the battle. I am proud to see my daughter no longer as a child. She is a mastermind philosopher and she's intelligent. That is great. We could marry her to someone. A populist uprising? No. Come on closer to home. These people are so far. Let's see, what can we do? Maybe get the 70-year-old boy matrilinearly. Definitely, let's keep our people in our court, right? Good, we've taken over the territory. Now we just have to sit still for a while. Gonna disband. I am going to go for thriving in chaos, even though we don't really have stress. But it's going to protect us in the future. Titles can be created. We can have a few more kingdom titles. Do we want to call some house members here and there? A curse undone. So Duke Cyril, he died. He was pretty good, all in all, even with the bribery for killing one of our family members. He was pretty good. Let's see, you have 869 soldiers. You have 23, 611, 960, where are you? Oh, he's here in the north. So Ross, will I be able to declare war on you? I guess we could. Okay, what else? You are part of what title? So he has the title of Sudreyar. Okay, I think we can wait for the free war score necessary without fighting. He's now a novice physician, that is good. Anything that can increase our abilities there is perfect. They Attelwulf comes to age. Nice, he is now an astute intellect with an intelligent. That's great. Let's see, where are we at as far as religion goes? This is insular. The insular Christianity has been spread around everywhere. Asaru, there's Astaru here and there. Adamites, we should probably convert some of these. Let's see, are we where? How close are we to having 30? Okay, let's enforce. Now we have the Isles of Man. And we can construct some new buildings here. There's nothing here. Emperor or peasant, high and low. So we are sick, we are ill now. How good are you? You are at 18. Do no more than is necessary? Yeah, let's do that. Wolf brought a concoction made from butthorn and senna. At first I thought the potion ineffectual, but later the same day I felt a churning in my bowels which sent me running for the privy. As I howled in anguish, Wolf assured me that the foulness was expelled with my feces. In the end, the cleansing turned out to be just what I needed. Excellent work. Huge health boost. We're probably not going to die anytime soon. Okay, we can't push there with the war, but we can do it here. So yeah, we are going to go to war with Sudreyar once more. We missed that opportunity to get the territory earlier, but that's going to be a goal for the next time. As for the moment, I thank you very much for watching, and I wish you all a wonderful day.